What is Thomas Edison's greatest contribution to our society? I'll give you 1 second to think. If you answered it was the light bulb, you'd be mistaken. In actuality, it's film. Now, I'm not going to tell you the whole story of how Edison created Hollywood, but I do want to talk about his works in film. I imagine you have some questions, so we can jump right into it. The Wizard of Menlo, Big Al, the father of the light bulb, the patent princess. Thomas Edison is a scientist well known for his invention, a man ahead of his time, but not really. By now, we all know that he was really the man that stole other people's ideas and claimed ownership. I'm so glad we don't have that going around these days. Just to give you an idea, Thomas Edison had a total of 1,093 patents, but popularly we only know of a handful. One of those would be the light bulb or the kinetoscope. The kinetoscope being one of the earliest motion picture cameras out there. These of which are where he made his directorial debut. That was it. That was his first film. A man sneezing. Just imagine filming somebody sneeze. That's as impactful as like driving down the highway and a grasshopper hitting your windshield. Nothing. But back in 1894, a fucking blockbuster. That's what I want to dive into today. Thomas Edison produced films, and believe me, Edison was cranking out movies like a 15-year-old girl with a healthy family dynamic, but still posts on social media for pedophiles, posts her TikTok dances. In actuality, I think Edison might have been a true inspiration to a lot of directors these days. I mean, I really think Christopher Nolan took inspiration from a lot of Edison's films. I mean, the fact that both of these directors' films, and essentially you can't understand any of their dialogue, it's inaudible.
Documents are vulnerable to
fire. Absolutely, I was trying to say water damage.
And the usage of black and white for no real reason? Genius. You know, he not only created cinematic masterpieces, but viral internet content before the internet was even thought of? He was making the most classic YouTube videos. Cat videos. With his boxing cat film. He was even making parkour bike trick videos with his bicycle trick riding number 2. He was even in the commercial game, the advertisement game for cigarettes. Unfortunately, there was some dark sides, some dark elements to his films, including not only the cat boxing video, that might raise some eyebrows, but how about executing a whole ass elephant, which the ASPCA signed off on? I'm not gonna show it on here, but it just seems like a darker subject to document. Just imagine an elephant with Sarah McLachlan singing In the Arms of the Angels playing in the background. Filming cockfights, it was certainly a novel that captures motion pictures, and it certainly led to a lot of questions that we still ask ourselves today. Should everything be filmed? Edison went on to produce many different kinds of films, including even some of the earliest book-to-film adaptations with Mary Shelley's Frankenstein and The Patchwork Girl of Oz, which is the 7th installment of the Wizard of Oz collection, you know that. I really just wanted to talk about this because I thought it was interesting. I never really thought of Thomas Edison as a film director, just the guy who kicked Nikola Tesla's ass in the electrical race.
History is getting rewritten, and I have read your best invention was a word to steal credit.
Without me, here's a taste of what this battle would be. No lights, no camera, no sound. See?
And if the people knew you stopped me from making power free,
they would curse the Con Edison with every utility.
I hope y'all found this as interesting as I did. If you did, feel free to spank that subscribe button. It keeps the lights on. These are new lights. I hope y'all stay safe out there. Hey, thanks for sticking with me. All right, y'all have a good night. Stay safe, and I'll see you later.